Now that we know all this cool history about notifications in Android, let's go ahead and add some to our toy app. We'd like to get our hydration app to launch a notification every now and then to remind us to drink our much-needed glasses of water. We also want the notification to launch the app when we click on it, so that we can click on the cup and update the count when we're done drinking. Creating notifications are pretty straightforward, as we will see very soon. But to get the notification to launch the app when clicked, we first need to learn about something called pending intents. You've already seen and used intents a couple of times before. Intents allows your application to launch various activities within the same app or launch other applications altogether, either explicitly or implicitly using URIs. Launching other apps or services from your own application requires the manifest to include the appropriate permissions. But what if we want another application to launch an activity in your own application? Like in the case with notifications. Any notification in Android is displayed by a system service called Notification Manager. A system service is a service that starts by the Android system itself and is not part of your application processes at all. Which means if you want the Notification Manager to be able to launch an activity in your application, you needed to have the permissions to do so. And since you can't modify the system's service permissions, pending intents come to play. A pending intent is a wrapper around a regular intent that is designed to be used by another application. The pending intent gives that application the ability to perform the included action as if it was your application, with all the permissions your application has been granted. It can launch services, private activities, and broadcast protected intents, even if your application is no longer running. This works great for the notification service, because we want to be able to launch the hydration activity from the notification pop-up even if the app was closed. To create a pending intent instance, you can use one of those static methods in the pending intent class, either getActivity, or getService, or getBroadcast, depending on what intent you want to wrap in the pending intent. All of those calls require four parameters when called. In the getActivity, for example, the four parameters are as follows. The first one is the context. The first one is the context in which the pending intent should start the activity. The second is a request code integer that helps you if you need to cancel that pending intent at any time. So make sure that this is a unique for each pending intent you create. Then, the actual intent you want the other application to launch. And then finally, one of those flag options to handle creating multiple pending intents for the same intent. If you plan to just create a single pending intent for an intent, then you could use either flag update current or flag cancel current. Here's a sample code for creating pending intents using the getService method. Notice that this method call returns an actual instance of the pending intent that you will pass to another app, which in our case will be the Notification Manager. And then you can expect the Notification Manager to launch our activity when the user clicks on the notification. Okay, enough talk. Let's get back to coding and get this notification up and running.